Hello everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a time adder. So first, I would give the current time in hour, minute, and second. And then I would like to move the time forward by inputting the hour, minute, and second to move forward. After that, I will do the evaluation of the new time by using the addition of time. So let us see how it can be done. I would like to input some values to represent the current time as well as the time to add. So I need a scanner object. So first I import the scanner package. Okay, so after importing the package, I can use the scanner object later. So first I would like to create a scanner object reference called scan. Okay, the variable name called scan is storing the object reference to a scanner object. And here system.in is the input argument for the scanner class, which means I'm going to receive input from the keyboard. After that, I can ask the user to input the current time. For example, I can ask the user to input the current hour. So I need a variable to store the value received by the user input. I assume that the user would input an integer, so I would use an integer variable called current hour to store the user input. So I can do similar things for the minute and the second. Okay, I have three variables to store the current hour, minute, and second. So the next step is to ask the time to go forward. So I would ask the user to input the hour, minute, and second to go forward. The process is quite similar to the previous part, so I can use the copy and paste action. And of course, I need some new variables to store the time to go forward. So I would use forward hour to store the time of hour to go forward, forward minute, and forward second. So these three variables would accept the user input about the time to go forward. So I can go to the real calculation part. First, I need some variables to store the final answer. I call the answer to the hour, answer hour. So I can do something similar to store the minute and the second for the answer. I would initialize all these three variables to zero. When we do the addition of time, it is possible that we have some result which is larger than 60 minutes or 60 seconds. In this case, we would have a carry digit. So we need the variables to store the carry digit. So we would have two variables to store the carry digit for the second and the minute addition. It is possible that the time adding result would lead to another day, so it is quite sensible to have a variable to consider the situation. I would use a Boolean variable to address this issue. For now, we assume that we don't meet the situation. So we set the variable is next day to be false. Okay, we can do the addition. So the second value would be equal to the summation of the current second and the forward second. Of course, we have to address the issue of the second value being larger than 60. Okay, we can see that if the answer for the second is larger than or equal to 60, we need to make it less than 60. So I need to subtract 60 from the original answer about the second. And we also need to address the carry digit by setting the carry second to be equal to 1. We can do similar things for the minute part for my answer. Okay, since it is possible that we have a carry digit from the second answer, this carry digit will be converted to 1 minute. So I have to add carry second in the answer part of the minute section. Okay. So if there is no carry digit, this variable will still be zero. Okay, I do similar things with the second answer to the minute answer. Pretty similar things for the hour answer. So we have to consider the case when the sum of the minutes is larger than or equal to 60. If it is the case, there is a carry digit from the minute answer, which is carried to the hour part of the answer. So we would add 1 hour to the answer if it is the case. Okay. I need to do some exchanges here as well. So the conditional statement here would address the issue when the our part of the answer is larger than or equal to 24. It means that we will go to the next day. So I would set this next day variable to be true. So after that, I can print out the answer by considering whether it is going to become the next day or not. Okay, this is the answer if the sum of the two time instants would go to the next day. I would print out the hour, minute, and second on the next day. If we don't go to the next day, we can print out similar things. But in this case, we don't need to mention the next day because we still get the answer on the same day. Okay, let us try to run it. Save it and run it. Suppose the current hour is 3, the minute is 15, the second is 45. The time to go forward is, for example, 6 hours, 45 minutes, and 30 seconds. So the answer would be 10 o'clock, 1 minute, and 15 seconds. How can we get this answer? We handle the addition of the second first. 45 plus 30 would be 75. So that means we would have a carry digit from the second part of the answer. And after handling the carry digit, the second would become 15. So we will have one a minute to the answer part. Current minute is 15 and the minute to add is 45. So these two values would add up to 60 together with the carry digit from the second part which is converted to 1. We will have 1 minute as the answer. We have to carry the digit coming from the minutes section to the hour section. So 3 plus 6 is originally 9, but after we handle the addition issue, we would have 10 as the hour answer. So this is one of the possible cases of the time addition. We would have similar treatment when we want to subtract time from another time. My approach is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not always be the best solution or the most efficient solution. If you can think about any idea to improve my code, please feel free to do so on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.